Welcome dear students, this video describes class 9 geography lesson number 7 international dateline module 2. Before proceeding further for module 2, let's have quick recap what we have studied in our lesson number 7 international dateline in module 1. In the beginning, we have studied the concept of standard time. So, the world standard time is determined by 0 degree meridian, also known as prime meridian. This prime meridian passes through Greenwich. This time also known as GMT, that is Greenwich Mean Time. So, the world standard time, that is Greenwich Mean Time, and the IST, also known as Indian Standard Time. So the Indian Standard Time is the time zone observed in India. Indian Standard Time is determined by 82.5 degree East Meridian. So student, you have to remember that there is a difference of 5 hours and 30 minutes between GMT, that is Greenwich Mean Time, and the IST, that is Indian Standard Time. The longitude difference between Mirzapur and the United Kingdom's Royal Observatory at Greenwich, an exact time difference of 5 hours and 30 minutes. So the latitudinal distance between London and the Mirzapur, which is located in India, is the reason for the difference in the time. So the time difference between GMT and the IST is 5 hours 30 minutes. So student, please remember that Indian Standard Time is 5 hours 30 minutes ahead of GMT, that is Greenwich Mean Time. Also in our module 1, we have learned about the activity. So through the activity, we have studied the standard time of various countries. Countries located to the east of India had already celebrated the beginning of New Year before India. However, in countries located to the west of India, New Year begins quite late in compared to India. Different countries have celebrated the beginning of New Year either ahead of or later than India. Then we have studied the activity. Through the activity, we had learned the minor journey. In our lesson number 7, international dateline in module 2, let's see what are we going to learn. So in this module, we will learn about the Sunil journey. As all of you know that in our previous module, we have studied about the minor journey. Similarly, in this module also, we will take the information about Sunil journey. Also, we'll concentrate on international dateline. In this, we'll take information in detail about the need of international dateline and the significance of international dateline. Student, you all know that in a previous module, that is in a module 1, we had learned about the minor journey. Now, let's begin our module 2 by understanding Sunil journey. Let's see the journey of Sunil with the help of the image. Now again, in this image, you can see that Sunil is moving towards the eastern direction. Well, Sunil is at 0 degree meridian. What is the timing over here? Yes, you can see that here it is already mentioned. So the timing is the same, that is Thursday afternoon 12 o'clock as Minal was having. So we can say that Sunil started his journey from 0 degree meridian on Thursday at 12 o'clock in the afternoon. Now you can see here Sunil is going ahead, not the behind. So what will be the timing at 30 degree east meridian? As all of you know that already we have studied in a module 1 that from 0 degree meridian to 30 degree meridian, total how many longitudes are there? Yes, correct. Total 30 longitudes are there. So means how many hours? Yes, 2 hours. Now again, we had to count 12, 1, 2. So at 30 degree east meridian, Sunil will have 2 p.m. that is Thursday. So we can say that at 30 degree east meridian, it will be Thursday 2 p.m. in the afternoon. Now again, Sunil is traveling towards 60 degree east meridian. Now from 30 degree to 60 degree east. So what will be the timing at 60 degree east meridian? Now again, 2 hours differences. So let's count once again. 2, 3, 4. So at 60 degree, it will be Thursday 4 p.m. That is Thursday evening 4 o'clock. Now again, he is moving towards the 90 degree east meridian. So student, you all know that from 60 degree east to 90 degree east, there is a difference of 2 hours. So at 60 degree east meridian, it will be 4 p.m. Thursday. So now here again at 90 degree east meridian, it will be 6 p.m. that is Thursday 6 o'clock in the evening. Similarly, from 90 degree east to 120 degree east meridian, again 2 hour differences. So what will be the timing at 120 degree east meridian? Yes, it will be 8 p.m. Thursday. That is Thursday 8 o'clock will be there at 120 degree east meridian. Now student, you must have noticed that we studied about the minimum journey. That time at 90 degree west meridian, it was 6 a.m. that is 6 o'clock in the morning. But now here, if you will see, at 90 degree east, it is 6 p.m. that is 6 o'clock in the evening. So you can see a straight line, but opposite longitudes you can see here. Now again, Sunil is moving from 120 degree east to 150 degree east meridian. So what will be the timing again here? Now 2 hour differences. Again let's count from 8. So 8, 9, 10. Then we can say that at 150 degree east, it will be Thursday 10 p.m. that is 10 o'clock at night. Now again, Sunil is traveling from 150 degree east meridian towards 180 degree meridian. Now again, 2 hours differences. It means at 150 degree east meridian, it is Thursday 10 p.m. Now at night at 180 degree, let's count from 10, 10, 11, 12. It means 12 o'clock midday will be at 180 degree meridian. Now here, when Sunil will cross 180 degree meridian, he will enter into the new day. That means Thursday is over for him. So what is the next day? Thursday after Friday. So Sunil will enter into Friday. And if you have noticed the minimal journey, she will enter into the Wednesday. So student, what we have learned from this activity? So we have studied that different timing at different meridian. Students, all of you know that in a previous slide, we had learned about the Sunil journey. Now, let's complete the table which is given on your geography textbook, page number 58, Sunil observation, table B. Let's complete the table. As all of you know that in already we had learned that the Minal journey and the Sunil journey, it is just the opposite what Minal had. Here, Sunil is going 2 hours more ahead. So here you have seen at 30 degree east, he had timing 2 o'clock, whereas at 60 degree east, Thursday, he had timing 4 p.m. At 90 degree east, Thursday, 6 p.m. that is 6 o'clock in the evening. Again, at 120 degree east meridian, Thursday, 8 p.m. 8 o'clock in the evening. At 150 degree east meridian, Thursday, and the timing he had 10 o'clock at night. At 180 degree, Thursday, and the timing is 12 midnight. So when he will cross 180 degree meridian, so what will happen? The day will change. So day is meridian 150 meridian, and the day is Friday, and the timing will be 2 o'clock. At 120 degree west meridian, day Friday, and the timing is 4 a.m. 90 degree west, Friday, 6 a.m. Again, 60 degree west, Friday, 8 a.m. At 30 degree west meridian, Friday, 10 a.m. So, when he reached at 0 degree Greenwich, so day was Friday and the timing was 12 o'clock in the afternoon. So, student, so what we have understood? So much of confusion both of them are having, such as Meenal and the Sunil was passing the 180 degree meridian, but one is going to the next day and one was going to the previous day. Let's see the geographical explanation. Student, you must have learned in your previous standard about rotation and revolution of the earth. Sunrise and the sunset are the natural phenomena. Now student, let's take a quick recap about rotation and revolution of the earth. As all of you know that earth rotates means the rotation of the earth planet around its own axis. When the earth rotates around its own axis, it is called as rotation. Now what is the movement of the earth rotation? Yes, earth rotates from west to east. Therefore, in terms of time, the eastern part of the earth is ahead of the western part. So the eastern part of time is ahead of the western part. You also know that earth takes 24 hours to complete one rotation. Now what is meant by revolution? Revolution means the movement of earth around the sun. As you can see in this image, the earth revolves from west to east, and earth takes 365 days to complete one revolution. Student, we all know that man has studied the rotation speed direction, that is earth rotate from west to the east direction, and the shape of the earth, and he prepared the chronometric system, that is timekeeping system, for his own purpose and the benefit. Students, all of me know that our earth is in a spherical in shape. So considering the shape of the earth, man defined graticule on the earth. As all of you know about the graticule, so graticules are the network of lines of latitude and the longitude. So here he coordinated between the time of the earth rotation and the meridians of graticule. You also know that earth takes 24 hours to make one rotation. Earth takes 24 hours to make a rotation of 360 degree around itself. Students, we all know that in a previous standard, we have learned that earth rotates from west to the east. Therefore, in terms of the time, the eastern part of the earth is ahead of the western part. Now, keeping this in mind, let's think about the Sunil journey. Now, talking about the Sunil journey, Sunil is moving towards the eastern direction. Therefore, the timing will move ahead at different meridians. Let's take example to understand. At 90 degree east meridian, it will be Thursday 6 p.m. that is Thursday 6 o'clock in the evening. Sunil moved eastward and according to him, it will be Thursday midnight, that is 12 o'clock at 180 degree meridian. Now again, according to him, as he continues, it will be Friday after he crosses 180 degree meridian. So at 90 degree west meridian, it will be Friday 6 a.m. that is Friday 6 o'clock morning. And therefore, after the full round of the earth, when Sunil meets at 0 degree meridian, it will be Friday afternoon 12 p.m. Now, let's consider the Minal journey. As Minals move towards the western direction, she will see that the timing is moving backward. Let's take example to understand. At 30 degree west, it will be 10 hours in the morning, that is 10 o'clock in the morning on Thursday, while it will be 8 a.m. on Thursday at 60 degree west meridian, and it will be 12 midnight at 180 degree meridian. If Minal continues ahead, then it will be Wednesday 6 p.m. at 90 degree east meridian. When she will complete her full journey and return back to 0 degree meridian, then according to her, it should be Wednesday afternoon. Now, there is a debate between Minal and the Sunil when they meet each other at their respective journey. So, according to Minal, it should be Wednesday, and according to Sunil, it should be Friday. Then, where does the Thursday go? Let's see. Students, all of you know that in a previous slide, we have seen that Minal and the Sunil, they were confused regarding the dates during their journey. Now, let's see what is the solution to the confusion of days with the help of the image. As you can see in this image, when you cross the 180 degree meridian, some precautions need to be taken. Meridian of 180 degree reach after 12 hours from the prime meridian. As all of you know that about the prime meridian also known as a 0 degree meridian. So, if you go from east or west, accordingly an adjustment or change in a day and time is made. According to the convention, the start and end of the day is considered to be at 180 degree meridian. So student, please remember that the start of the day is considered at 180 degree meridian. As you can see here, the red color arrow shows 180 degree meridian. So the 180 degree meridian is kept as the start of the day. So the day is going to change at 180 degree meridian. So there were certain conditions for it when the international dateline was drawn. As you can see in this map, the international dateline is shown with the pink color line. Let's see what are these conditions. Direction of travel, and the second one is the current day and the date. Now, when we talk about the direction of travel, it means whether you are going towards the eastern direction or whether you are going towards the western direction, that is the direction of travel. And the current day and date, it means on which day and date you will start your journey. Now, talking about the international dateline, student, as you can see here, international dateline is shown with the pink color line. So this pink color line is not a straight line. Sometime it's bent towards the eastern side. Sometime it's bent towards the western side. So here you have to remember one thing, that adjust the opposite to the prime meridian is the 180 degree meridian, and prime meridian is a straight line. Now here one more thing you have to remember, that international deadline is drawn to overcome the problem of 24 hours differences. The day and date is always ahead by one day in the western of international date line than the day and date running to the east of international date line. Therefore, when the international date line is crossed while traveling towards the western direction, one day is added to the day and date of original travel, whereas a previous day is considered when one crosses international date line while traveling towards the eastern direction. Now let's take few examples to understand the international date line. While traveling from Japan to America, we need to consider the existing day and date even after crossing the international date line. For example, if it is Thursday 25th December, then Thursday 25th December only should be considered. On the other hand, while going from America to Japan and crossing international date line, one need to add a day to the date. So if it is Thursday 25th December, then it will be Friday 26th December. Now let's take few more examples to understand international date line. Shamrav left for America, which lies to the east of international date line, that is IDL, from Japan, and Japan lies to the west of international date line on first Monday, that is 1 o'clock in the afternoon. After traveling for 24 hours in a flight, he reached to the America and he saw the date there, and it was Monday 1st 1 p.m. in the afternoon. Now let's see the another example of Shamrav. Now here in this example, Shamrav left for Japan. As all of you know that when we talk about the international date line, Japan lies to the west of IDL, that is international date line, from America, and America lies to the east of international date line on Friday 5th at 12 o'clock in the afternoon. Then he reached Japan after traveling 24 hours in a flight, and he reached to the Japan, and that time the date was Saturday 12 o'clock in the afternoon. Now student, in this example you must have noticed that he reached to his destination, that is in Japan. So the one day is added. Now why it is so? Because you all know that in this example, when he crossed the international date line while traveling towards the west, one day is added to the day and the date of the original travel. Whereas in the previous example, a previous day is considered when he crosses the international date line while traveling towards the eastern direction. Now students, when we talk about international date line, the day on the earth starts in the west and ends in the east. It is one and the same day, only at 12 o'clock midnight and the 180 degree meridian. Let's take example to understand. For the countries which are lying to the east of international date line, that is USA and Chile, it is the end of the day. Whereas for the countries which are lying to the west of IDL, that is Japan, and Australia. It is the start of a new day. Now, student, a question may come to your mind that why don't the dates change with respect to 180 degree meridian? Why is the international dateline required? Now, here is the answer. International dateline is very useful in keeping good coordination between the date and day, which always changes due to travel. International dateline is also helpful in managing proper schedule of traffic worldwide. Now, let's take more information about international dateline. Student, all of you know that a 24 hours day start at 12 midnight. Because of the earth rotation, midnight occurs at different times and different places. You also know that as the earth is spherical in shape, every place has a place to its east. Then at what location to the east does the day start on the earth? So, to get an answer to many questions like this, representatives of many nations got together under the leadership of American Professor Davidson in the year 1884, and they decided on the international dateline. Students, all of you know that international dateline is not a straight line like 180 degree meridian. Here you can see the international dateline, which is bending towards the western direction as well as towards the eastern direction. The line was drawn opposite to the Greenwich prime meridian, that is with reference to the 180 degree meridian. It is an international convention to change the day and time while crossing the international dateline. Now, let's see what consideration have been made while deciding international dateline. Students, all of you know that in a previous slide, we have learned about international dateline. So, here also you can see international dateline is not a straight line like 180 degree meridian. 180 degree meridian is a straight line. It passes even on land, part of the same country. If 180 degree meridian itself was considered as ideal, it would have caused a great confusion of two different days and days in the same country. Therefore, an attempt was made to make the ideal, that is international dateline, pass through sea or the ocean or the water bodies. As you can see here, international dateline passed through the Pacific Ocean completely. Besides, it was also ensured that a group of islands belonging to one country shall come to one side of the ideal, and hence ideal is not a straight line at places eastern, east or the western direction. Now, let's see the importance of international dateline. Student, please remember that international dateline plays an important role in today's modern era and rapidly happening global development. International dateline brings the coordination between various activities such as international airlines, transportation services, economic and trade activity. It also helps to keep a track of all the calculation of the day and time accurately. We can keep a track of all the calculations of day and time accurately with the help of international dateline in case of global transportation, especially with respect to airways. It is only because of the international dateline that the schedules of traffic worldwide are organized properly. Now, student, let's take quick recap what we have studied till now in our lesson number 7, International Dateline Module 2. In the beginning, we had learned the concept of international dateline. So, we have studied about the international dateline with the examples and the activity. So, the international dateline is an imaginary line drawn to the opposite of Greenwich prime meridian, that is with reference to 180 degree meridian. International dateline is decided to overcome the confusion of 24 hours differences. Also, we have studied about the day and the date. So, in international dateline, we have studied that the day and date is always ahead by one day in the west of international dateline than the day and date running in the east of international dateline. Although the international dateline is drawn with reference to 180 degree meridian, international dateline is not a straight line like 180 degree meridian. In order to pass IDL only on ocean areas, international dateline is turned to the east or the west of 180 degree meridian. Hence, international dateline is not a straight line. In other words, international dateline is drawn in a such a way to avoid passing over the land. So, student, at the end of a chapter, we have learned about importance, also known as significance of international dateline. So, the international dateline help us to bring the coordination between transportation, communication, airlines, transport, and international trade. International dateline helps to keep a track of all the calculation of the day and time accurately. It is because of the international dateline that the schedule of traffic worldwide is organized properly. So, student, till now we are completed with our lesson number 7, international dateline.